This is June 17, 1982. I'm Jim Brown, and I'm going to the house of Mr. John Mealing at 1201 6th Place, Pratt City, in Birmingham, Alabama. Now I'm trying to see if the machine is working.
I told Jim Brown last night, I said, John, if he cheats, I'll beat anybody you ever hear calling the track. I said, because John's a good church member, and say he's called the track. They get happy out there.
Yeah. Well, now this boy, he was calling when I learned how. That was in 1928.
That was when you were still on the Western?
I was still on the Western.
He
was
south of Montgomery.
Yeah, out from Montgomery. That's going to Wall-Sell. He always made a man felt good. When a man wagged down on the railroad, he gives out. But you got to have something to boost. And that's how I started. And I was telling him when I come out of Birmingham and they were lining the track going around from 15th Street to Western Green. You know where Western Green is. That's on 17th, going around the 17th Street. And we were lining that track and they couldn't move it. Everybody started, they couldn't move it. So my foreman told me to get up there and talk to him. And I went up there. He took everything from me and gave me a pick handle. That's all you need. Just test the rail where I want you to get out. And that's what I've done. And I started singing. Because he told me, talk your Latin. Just like that. Then I started. He was there. And that track just moved. Just went on over there. The fellas got uplifted. That's what that song was for. To make a man feel good. Because if he gives out, you just will sit down and let him rest. But if he's down and out and somebody can really talk it, he'll get uplifted. And I have did that a many times. I went on rakes and folks were so close to the track we couldn't move. Falling us, every which way we go. Every time us move down, they move down. Women and men, children, white and black, just keep right over this rat jam there to make them get back. They listened at me, and everybody answered.
John was good.
Huh?
I told him he was good.
Yeah, that's the way it was.
The reason I give him his name, you want to...
Can you do that here without
well,
a scratch?
Well, I might could do some of it, but see, here what that is. It's a time. You carry the time with it. You don't just jump and go, you carry time. Because see, when the man calling, he start the time. Hey, hey. Then everybody else answer him when he called. Hey, hey, yeah. Then I start, well, come on, boy, let's go around the wall. Don't want to stumble and I don't want to fall. That suits me. And then all of them lying, see, he going over. When I say that, hey, hey, and they're all up. Hey, hey, it's going over. But they said, Captain can't read, Captain can't write, Captain can't tell when the track is right. Come on, move it, whoop! Yeah, come on, move it, whoop! And it's gone. That's the way you have to do it. See, and I figured, see, I don't like to study nothing. It worries you. Now, you worried me last night. Because when you called me, I went to bed with it on my mind, trying to satisfy somebody with something. Well, that's what I had to satisfy 60 and 70 men on the job. So that's the song. But it said, hey, boy, hey, hey. The answer. He said, oh, John, hey, then quarterback. That's the way we line the track. Can you move it? Oh, can you move it? Yeah. Oh, can you move it? Yeah. Well, I went on down the line today. Found myself, I was giving away. Can you move it? Yeah. Oh, can you move it? Yeah. Oh, can you move it? Yeah. Well, my captain can't read, my captain can't write, captain can't tell when the track is right. Can you move it? Yeah. Well, can you move it? Yeah, but see, it's gone. That's all to it.
He's good,
Was there one or two verses you specialized in, or did you make them up as you went along?
Well, you see, they're already in there. They're already in there. You don't have to, nobody don't have to tell you what to say. It's already in there. Because I got a heap of them was packed back there. Because you got some you said, shoot my dice, a pint was nine, six come running and Trey come to flying, can you move it? Good boy, can you move it? And they move it every time you say that. Yeah, me and my wife had a falling out. Stop, let me tell you what the trouble's about. She jumped at me, and I give her a load. She wanted me to wag on the Southern Railroad. Can you move it? Oh, boy, can you move it? And that's it. It's on down back there. So I didn't know how far you wanted to go, how long you wanted to take.
I've got 2 hours to take here, but I hadn't got any money to pay for 2 hours of work. Did you have any verses about girlfriends or women? Or was you singing for mixed company with these crowds along? Or is there something you just sang for the men?
Well, I would, but see, heap of them words I wouldn't say. Because, see, I was...
A big church member.
Yeah, I was in another field.
He's happy on that, just like in church, yeah. Just like he is, yeah, like wood on the rail.
Yeah. See, heap of them I wouldn't say.
Or his house.
Well, now, heap of my hood, I know they're saying. So, them boys didn't care. Don't care who he is. But see, I wouldn't. So that's the way that was. And you say, like I said, I love my wife, I love my baby. Like my flapjack swimming in the grave. Boy, move it. Hey, boy, can you move it? Hey, boy, can you move it? I went on down by trap to fall. I found myself I didn't want no more. Can you move it? Hey, boy, can you move it? Hey, boy, can you move it? See, all that in it. But see, he put an old bad part of it that I would say. Yeah, it's deeper. But I was trying to think of going that old boy down the country to say, some of it it got to come to me.
You ain't saying all you used to say.
Huh?
You ain't saying half you used to say.
Yeah. Yeah, see, when you get caught up sometimes, it ain't like it was when I was waiting. So when I was waiting, I stayed ready all the time. So yeah, I know you don't have to make somebody feel good. You said about the captain, he's standing out there like a railroad man. He looked like a foreman and they do a railroad man. See, all that's in it. You do that to get back at the foreman. Yeah, captain got a water barrel just like mine. You wind it up, it won't keep no time, and you move it. Hey, boy, can you move it? You want to quit then when you say that. Because he know he ain't got time. He don't know what time it is. So that's the way that is. But some more of them, but I just can't think of more right now. Because, see, I've been out of 10 years.
As you're going to work, would you think of these and get them ready in your mind? Or would they just come to you when you're...
Oh, yeah, they just come to me. See, I already have them stacked back. And they'll come to me and see, they lack out here like it is now. So you be out there while nothing but a bunch of men. And you just gonna pour it out. And just like eat him up whispers, he won't shave, eat him up crab life, he won't bathe. Like that. See, all that is on the camp.
Yeah.
See, because you had fellas on the camp who didn't want to take a bath. Well, you talking about them all the time. Heap of that stuff, I just can't think right off the beam. Because I've been messing around with him so long. And I've been in another field where I don't have to worry about it. But back then, I used to have to stay there with
him. Let me see if these things work. Now I got away from that air conditioner. Let me ask you to do one.
Yeah, I thought to tell
two,
you to
two or three of them again. I don't care if they're the same ones or not. Just
Let me see. Let me get it one lined up there. Huh?
That
air is a decent mixture. Oh, yeah. It sure do that.
It picks up more on the machine than you hear it. You don't hear it in the room, but this machine just kind of picks it.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Anything like a TV or anything like that will come out here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm trying to think of what Eddie said on some of them on 928. Huh?
He's taking longer than
you think. Yeah, that was 1928 when he come through there and I was waking there with him. I was just there listening.
Is that the man you learned from?
Oh, yeah, that boy what was calling back that end. I know he did. And I was just there listening, waking and listening. And he done the singing and I loved it because it made you feel good. When he had a good voice. But, this gang, this crowd I had here, they got they didn't want to do nothing until you sang. Old Lodge and Leslie and all of them, they didn't want to move till I sang. And they really read that and they'll move that track. Yeah.
Just think of some of
them songs
you sang.
Huh?
Think of some of them you called.
Okay. Let me see. Yeah, I woke up this morning about 4:30. Somebody knocking on my door. Boy, move it. Hey, move it. Hey, move it. Come on, boy, let's go around the wall. Don't want to stumble and don't want to fall. Let's move it. Let's move it. Let's move it. Me and my wife had a falling out. Now stop, let me tell you what it was about. She jumped at me and I give her a load. She wants me to work on the Southern Railroad. Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? I got my learning on number 4. Boy, I'm telling you, I'm ready to go. Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? Oh, John Ahead, quarterback now. That's the way we line this track. Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? I got a gal, her name is Kate. She moving in her hip like a Cadillac gate. Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? A handful of nickels and pocket full of dime. House full of children ain't now mine. Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? Oh, my captain can't read, my captain can't write. Captain can't tell when the track is right. Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? Oh, my captain got a water bed just like mine. You wind it up, it won't keep no time. Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it? Well, I woke up this morning about 4:30. Boy, I'm telling you now, ready to go. Can you move it? Can you move it? Can you move it?
You sing these loud when you sing?
Oh, yeah, when it was loud. There you had to, because you had men strung off behind you sometime for me under that pole, yeah. Out there.
You hear
my
block.
Yeah, see, I had to be in the middle of them. And see, I test the rail where I wanted to get on. And then they all around me on each side. And I'm right in the middle. And you had to set something to make them all feel good. And I never got nobody hurt.
on job, even picking up rail when I call that. I never did get nobody hurt.
That's what Jim Randall called it, dogging.
Dogging, yeah. Dogging. When you got to move rail, you got to holler and let everybody know what your fingers do.
Is that a different kind of singing than
this? Oh, yeah, that's different from that. They're like when you're going to pick up something, you just say, hey, listen at me now, boys. Yeah. Dog your rail, son. Well, if I'm over this way, going to set on me. And all of them going to come to me. Now I want to go for set on me. And all of them come to me. That's all right. Move on down the line. Get on it. Hey, boy. What you going to do down there, man? Yeah. Just let me know they're ready. I want you to set on me. Go set on me. All right. So, man, got it in here. Well, look at here now, boys. I want you to set it in the center. Woo. You're all right. I want you to set it over the rail. Woo. And I want you to set it in the ditch. Yeah. And we put it in there. Come on, go and go with me. Then. Everybody come go with me. Get to them. All right, I'm dogging now, now, boy. Yeah. I want you to set in the center, man. All right, set the old rail. Set it in the ditch one time. All right, now come on, follow me. Oh, boy, dog him now, man. Yeah. Oh, look here. Can you do what I want you to do now, boys? Look here. Set it on the head, man. Yeah. Set it in the bed, man. Yeah. Giant iron on me, son. Boom. All right, move on down the line. Just tell them which way to go. And then, all right, now dog him again now, man. Yeah. Set on the head, man. Yeah. Set in the bed, man. Now, giant iron on me, man. Boom. Move on back down the line. See, that's the way when you land it.
What was the head? When you set it on the head.
What? That's the head of the tie.
Oh, that's that on the edge?
Yeah, that on the head of the tie. You know, your rail sitting here and that's your head of your tie out there. In, out here.
So when you
said
put it on the head, just lift it up on the tie.
Sit it up on the tie.
Put it over in the bed. Where
sit on, sit where the rail going to be.
Put it up against that other rail.
Yeah, that's what it is. Giant iron on me. And then all of them, when the giant, your head hit, boom. And then you said move on down line. You're going on down to the next rail.
Another rail.
That's right. So that's the way it is when you hold like that. And then when you...
I've heard folks get hurt pretty bad.
Oh, if you don't... If the man who called it don't get the main tension, you got to first get the attention. Everybody got to pay you attention and won't nobody get hurt. I've seen fellas get both legs broke. I've seen it done, get both legs broke by not knowing what you're going to do with that rail. So the man told me he tried to keep out of it. That was when I was on the Western. See, I want you to get on the dog, John. I told him, yeah, I'll get on the dog if you give me my buddy. If you give me my buddy to work with me, I don't mind getting on the dog. He said, well, you get your buddy. And I put my buddy in the scene. I'm going to stay over here while you're jumping it in the ditch. And I tell him, but now it's a slight in everything you done on the railroad. Somebody going to get by. I tell him, I said, now look at him, boy, don't you pick up on them dogs too hard. If you pick up on them dogs too hard, you overload me. I said, I'm outside. When you hold enough slack in there to keep up with the rail, keep the dogs on there. See, all them old big men is the one breaking the fella's leg. Setting it on them, didn't care. And I want to fix so I can put all them in the shade. And so he did. And it was time to holler, set on me. They come to me. And he keep up with the dog enough to stay on the rail and keep them falling. And I'm going upside the bank. My foot's up on the side of the bank. And them old big men give out. Oh, it was about 9 of them boots. Tall, big, healthy, so. And they got too hot. drinking that ice water, and they had to go home, and that so that left nobody but us little men. And we laid 15 miles of rail, quick as us would have did it with them bigger. Nothing but little men. But see, all of them was following me, and I never got nobody hurt. You remember Will Maxine? He got his leg broke up on 28th Street, mm-hmm. fooling around with the wrong man called.
Yeah,
he got his leg broke. See, he was on the head. Yeah, he was on the head. They were going to set the rail from him. But that boy changed quicker than I don't know what and sat it on and broke his leg. Sure did. And I wouldn't say nothing. Well, see, I wasn't the one calling. But that boy said that was Leslie calling. Yes. And you know what he said? I ain't gonna never call no more radio. Because he knew he was the calling that boy did. Hey.
The caller was the one that.
He was the responsible. The caller is the responsible for the game. Yeah, you got to tell them what you want done. And everybody got to listen at you. But see, if all of them don't know which way you're going, you're going to set on somebody. So he knew they called no more, not while I was there. I don't know what he's doing now.
Because everybody done retired quick with him.
Yeah.
Everybody
worked,
he's Charlie Wilson,
almost
2 foot.
That's the oldest one out there.
Charlie Wilson.
Less than Charlie.
Charlie, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You learn any of your singing in church?
What is that?
Did you learn any of this singing? How to sing in church?
In church? Lord, I sung quartet 37 years around here in Birmingham.
What kind of quartet? What's the name of it?
Gospel. Well, the last one I had was the Gospel Southern Air. I used to sing with this boy, Willie McKentry. You remember him, don't you?
He's famous, isn't he?
Huh?
He's one. He got in big time, didn't he?
Oh, yeah. We went all the way up.
He used to sing.
We had 2 years contract on television when I left. And I got a little girl, 27 years old, and she was, my wife was carrying her then when I left. Oh, I sing in church now sometime in opening devotion. But I don't fool with no quartet. Because I tell them, teaching the Sunday school lesson last Monday night, I was telling them about a song in that verse. And while Jesus went out of Jericho, and he was on that Jericho road going out. Blind Barnabas, you heard about him. He was sitting down there on the side of the road, begging. That's fuzz he got every day, begging. But he heard about Jesus was coming, and he found out Jesus was there. And then he went to crying to Jesus. And he said, Lord, have mercy on me. And all of them old Pharisees and things tried to stop him. Said, be quiet. But he got but the more worse by saying, Lord, have mercy on me. See, we used to sing that song, but that song come right out of the Bible. But old blind Barnabas stood on the way, head old blind Barnabas stood on the way, crying, oh Lord, have mercy on me. Well, that's what he said. So that's the song, and the other one is about when John was out on the island of Patmos. And John said, I saw. He wrote the whole of Revelation with I saw. And John was carried up in the spirit. And the spirit got all over him. Now see, he couldn't go to church. But the church went out there to him. See, God sent the church out there to him. And he told John to write Revelation. And John wrote, he said, I saw 24 elders bow down on their knees. And they all risen together and faced the rising sun. But the folk thought he was talking about that sun there. But that was Jesus. And he said in there, Lord, have mercy upon me. That's what them 24 elders said. And that song said, I see 24 elders on thy knees. I see 24 elders on thy knees, and they all rose together and faced the rising sun, and they said, Lord, have mercy if you please. Now that's a church song.
He good, ain't he?
You sang in church, you sang in quartet, and you sang out on the railroad.
Yeah, son.
You been singing ever since you were little?
Oh, ever since I was big enough.
What do you think about singing?
What I think about singing? Singing is praising the God.
Even on the railroad?
Well, singing on the railroad is a different set.
Taking it all together.
Yeah.
What do you think about singing?
Well, now all of that tune come from the same song. Now you can believe it or not, but in what I was saying on the railroad, the same tune come from the other song, and that come right out of the Bible. You take you don't know nothing about it, and I don't know nothing about it. But in the time of slaves, I got a Baptist hymn book in there, Baptist song book. Every song in there was sung by slaves, folks was enslaved. But they was depressed. And a person get depressed, the Lord gave him something to say. And they was depressed. Because you take it that song where it say in there say I'm gonna eat at the welcome table some of these days. I'm gonna eat at the welcome table some of these days. Lord, take care of me, help me on my way. I want to eat at the welcome table some of these days. Well, you know what that song was? Come from out the cotton patch. Folks was depressed. They was enslaved. And they had to eat. Walking along, they'd eat under the trees, eat on the steps. They couldn't get into a kitchen. Just like a Lazarus was. Lazarus was put there to eat the crumb that fell from the rich man's table. See? Well, he couldn't get up to the table. But if he could just get the crumbs fall from the table, and they'd sick the dogs on him. Because he was sick and he was full of soul. But the dog had mush on him. The Lord got in the dog. And the dog licked his soul that was on him. And he got healed by that. But he couldn't even go to the table to eat. He couldn't get the crumb that fell from the table. But that man went on to eat and forgot him. Finally, he died, and when he died, he went on to hell. Lazarus went on in Abraham's bosom. Rich man died. He told God to let Lazarus come, and dip his finger in some water to cool my parching tongue. But the Lord didn't do. You see, if he could have paid Lazarus to save him, he would have done it then. But you can't pay nobody after death. You got to pay him on this side. If you owe anybody an apology, now a lot of folks figure that money, but no, it's an apology. If you done told a lie on him or done treated him wrong, you owe it to him. Get right with him before you leave.